We go. But the A-Team, it's iconic. It's my favorite. Are you kidding? It's about people who live slash own a haunted hotel. He's a psychic. He can see the ghosts. She's a co-owner of the hotel. That's their friends who live with them. And it's their shenanigans. They have, he's the dad of her. They don't get along. Yeah, it's kind of dark, but I enjoyed it. They changed everything season two, so I lost interest. Then we have a black flame candle because of course. Okay. Beverly Hills 90210 seasons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 9. 3, 4, 5, and 9. Yeah. There's not a lot of rhyme or reason for why these seasons, other than Dylan was my favorite character and he wasn't in every season. Enjoyed it as they transitioned into like adults on the show, but I will say probably the earlier, like season 3 kind of content is probably my favorite. Beverly Hills 90210 is cheesy 80s goodness. It's about a group of friends in high school in Beverly Hills 90210 in the 80s. Lucky says hello. So she used to be a cop, but she was no longer able to do that. So she became a private detective, found out vampires are real, and then she and her former cop partner person all fight supernatural crime together. Boomtown was a show I liked at the time, but honestly, I don't think it really holds up. One crime seen from every point of view. It was interesting at the time. I never really watched it because it doesn't, like I said, it doesn't necessarily hold up. Buffy seasons 2 and 3. was enjoying it. I just got distracted. This show. I hated the ending. I have never been more offended by an ending in my life. But I hated that. But I loved the rest of the series. This is about John Crichton, who is an astronaut, and he's doing an experiment, and he accidentally goes through a wormhole and ends up on a ship with aliens. And now he's stuck trying to get home. Spun off from Jack, and this is about movies better, but I enjoy the cast. The Lost Empire, Reluctant Hero, Beautiful Goddess, 3 Days to Save the World. It has Thomas Gibson from Lines, and it is about the monkey god, the monkey king. Yeah. This is a TV miniseries. I actually like it so cheap. Like, to Roswell to care for her, well, basically to help her dad, like, run a restaurant. And when she arrives, she meets back up with her boyfriend, or kind of boyfriend from high school. They start up a thing. It turns out there's aliens. It's adorable. Okay. Encountering new aliens, communities, and cultures. as a family together. She's figuring out what it's like to have kids, and they're figuring out nostalgia for these DVDs. Wildly undecisive about it. Supernatural. Again, you probably have heard of it, but it follows Sam and Dean as they hunt monsters. It's the family business. I have no idea what else to tell you about that. There wouldn't be a spoiler based on wherever you are in the series. So, yeah, I love this little show. It is my absolute favorite. I have seen all of it. It sparks great joy. Teen Wolf, we have 1, 2, 3 part 1, 3 part 2, 4, 5 part 1. Is this one part 2? Yeah. 6 part 1 and 6 part 2. Is that all of it? I think they only have 6 seasons. Thank you. the person that knows nothing and has done nothing and is doing nothing. So if you're going to make a main character of the show, pick that most interesting person. It's not her. Okay. I'm just saying. It feels like that's pretty basic. The Walking Dead, this is complete first season. I stopped watching after about 5 seasons, but it's a really good show at the beginning and I enjoy it. To work with the FBI to solve white collar crime. I love Neil. Like, his character is just the best. And his FBI person, Peter, they're a great duo. Like, it's a crime solving duo. We've learned that I love Wolf Lake. Just talk about your